don't wanna write this down. I don't wanna tell you how I feel right now. I don't wanna take no time.
I'm doing street art where I'm taking my images and displaying it for public use. A lot of people that are in the neighborhoods that I serve, they won't go to a gallery or a museum, so I try to bring my images to them. So I will put up big posters of my artwork so that way people could either look at it, they can take it home if they want to, it's really for them. I'm a photographer. That's what I do for a living. I take pictures of people and I take pictures of things that I really like. I've been a youth advocate now for over 30 years. Children really saved my life. I was on a path leading to destruction. And when I started working with children, it made me look at myself in the mirror because I didn't want to be a hypocrite and tell them not to do the same things that I was doing.
That realization led photographer Erik James Montgomery to create his own foundation, teaching at-risk youth the art and business of photography. Eric calls one of his recent projects Kings and Queens.
That's a great shot. Kings and Queens was birthed out of the idea of influencing the younger generation to not only see themselves beyond the N-word, but to also see themselves as royalty. And if they see themselves as royalty, perhaps they'll talk different, they'll act different, and they'll treat each other a lot differently as well.
Wait a second, my head's too big for it.
What?
I don't believe you.
Eric grew up in East Orange, where he decided early on that he wanted to be a photographer.
My family had a large collection of album covers, and we would always play music, and I would look at these beautiful album covers for hours while listening to the music. One cover in particular was Al Green's I'm Still in Love with You. The way that he was sitting in that all-white background and his brown skin just bouncing off the LP. I went into the dark room, and that's when I really fell in love with photography. Well, after I left East Orange, I moved to a town not too far from Camden. But when I first drove through Camden, it reminded me a lot of Newark, and I felt at home. At that time, it was the world's most dangerous city. The murder rate was out of the stats, so it was crazy. Out of that, I saw people and not numbers. And there's poverty, but I see through all that and I see people with passion.
I don't wanna write this down. I don't wanna tell you how I feel right now.
So I will photograph somebody who has overdosed. I will also photograph somebody celebrating their 16th birthday, and I will give the same amount of attention to each subject. I'm trying to shine a light on the plagues that's going on out here.
In another project, Eric had middle school kids choose a single word to describe themselves. This was the starting point for making self-portraits.
Was we basically took a photo of ourselves, a self-portrait, and we basically chose a word that we want to describe ourselves, so instead of being defined as what other people see you. I chose the word beautiful.
And I did warrior because I went through some sicknesses. And for me, being able to fight them all, for me, is the biggest achievement. So that's why I can say I'm a warrior.
I chose Marina because I like to learn, and I always will continue to learn.
Sometimes we have to go through some hard times for the brighter day. That's ultimately what I want people to see and to take away when they view my work.
Thank you.
The New Jersey State Council on the Arts, encouraging excellence in public engagement in the arts since 1966, is proud to co-produce State of the Arts with Stockton University, New Jersey's distinctive university. Additional support is provided by the Geraldine R. Dodge Foundation and Bramnick Law, a personal injury law firm.